What's up, everybody? Tyler Caton here with Weld.com. Today, we're gonna be here at my shop, Dynamic Metal Innovations, building a welding fixture table. How to keep it straight while putting it together, and what's usefulness is. Now, you might be asking, okay, what's a welding fixture table specifically? It's this style table right here. It has a bunch of holes across the top, so that way you can secure your parts down, whether it be in the center when you're working on a big project, or if you just wanna secure something down here. That way, when you're not just on a regular flat top table, you don't have to bring everything to the edge and try to clamp it down on the edge. You can work anywhere that you need to on the table. Extremely useful. Let me get geared up. Let's get into it. So here's the table that we'll be building today. It is 2 foot by 4 foot by 3/16 inches thick material. Our holes are 5/8 in diameter on 2-inch centers. Now you immediately see all these ribs. Everything's tabbed and slotted. That way it just fits in really nicely. And the purpose of these ribs is to keep our tabletop here nice and straight. It'll keep everything flat and rigid. And that way, whenever you have a big piece or any kind of project that you're working on across the surface of the table, when you clamp it down, you're not gonna be bowing it. You know that you have a flat surface to work on. Luckily, when they shipped this, it already came with some 2x4s onto it. You can actually keep these on, and I would maybe get one more and cut it to the same length and then run it across your center. You can even do two more and run them across, you know, quarter it, and then I would cut pieces of wood the same length as these, and then just put them across your ribs and then lag them down the same exact way that they have these. And that way we know that it's getting clamped and pulled into the surface of the table, and we know for a fact that it'll be straight. So I would suggest taking 3 sawhorses, make sure they are rated for the amount of weight you're putting on them. That way you don't get hurt if anything breaks or falls. Take a level, put it across the top. You want to check the X and Y axis while you're doing this, and shim the horses so that way they are perfectly level, and then you can put the table on top of them and you know that you have a flat working surface. Now, let's say that you don't have saw horses and you don't want to go, and you don't have a table that you trust, or you simply don't have a table, that's why you're buying and building this, that you can build this on. So take some 4x4s, try to pick the straightest and flattest ones that you have. That way you can kind of trust that they are going to be straight, and put them across just like this, kind of on your ends and one in your center to support it. And the same thing, you know, cut that piece of wood there, and you're going to want to put it across the center of your center rib here along the whole axis, and make sure it's wide enough, because literally what we're going to do is we're going to lag the same way that these are through the holes of the table into that board with the pieces that we cut that go across each of these ribs. And now we know that everything is secure and tight and the ribs are sucked down to the table, which is gonna keep the table rigid and flat. So we actually cut these in house. That's just a clearance hole for a 1/2-inch bolt. It's just a nice little bracket. You can cut these on if you have a laser, if you have a plasma. You can make these, also it doesn't need to be anything fancy. Obviously clean away the slag because you want it to be flat, because this side will go against the surface of the table, and then this will go across the ribs, which on this side, it'll look like this. So you see how we can just run it right through the holes of the table, and then I'll pull our ribs down and keep it flat. So this is my 100 clamp method. We are using inserter clamps in the holes of the table themselves, and we are running square tubing across as our straight edge to pin all of the ribs down to the surface of the table. On the ends here, I just used F clamps and bar clamps and sucked everything down. Now, I did leave the wood on because that's how it came packed, and it's actually very helpful. If you don't have that option, you actually have to put the whole table together yourself, you can still use this method. Just grab other pieces of, you know, whatever kind of stock you have laying around that's pretty straight, and use it in the same way as this. It'll literally go the same way that the wood is going across right now, but it'll be a piece of metal and clamps instead of wooden lags. So our equipment we're using today is HTP's ProPulse 220 MTS. It is a multiprocessor. We're gonna be set up for MIG. So I'm going to be running with 035 wire and C10 gas mix on 20.5 volts and 322 wire speed. Normally, I wouldn't run this hot on a 3/16 thick material, but we're not going to be really putting a lot of weld onto the table itself, just some nice hot quick tacks. We may adjust as we go, but I basically want to keep any excessive heat out of the table, that way we don't have any warpage. So we're going to be tacking on where it's tab and slotted, so you see right there. So we'll be putting two tacks there, and then we'll be putting them in the corners. All right, and this is all we're looking for on the bottom here. Just tacks on all the tap and slotted spots just to secure it down in place. All right, so we're building the legs, the table. I set this up off camera, but this gives you a really good idea of exactly how useful one of these tables is. All right, off camera, I put the rest of this frame together. I know I kind of walked you through how I was securing it up. Again, I want to stress that it's not important that you have a specially tab and slotted table. If you have material laying around that you want to use to make your frame, you can absolutely do that. It's just uprights and some cross members, and you can make the dimensions how you need to based on what your table is. But another important thing for fitting and squaring this up, I know I'm using this fancy square that I can clamp to and clamp to my piece, but you can just use a combo square, a framing square, a machinist square, whatever you need to, hold it up and get them secure. Like I said, you can clamp one side down, whether you want to run a straight edge, you want to run those little blocks I was using and straighten out one piece against that, clamp that down, fit your other piece up, put your square on there, get it square, and then clamp your second piece down, double check your dimensions and tack it up. You can absolutely do that too. So let me finish up tacking this up and then we'll get the top on. All right, so here's the plate for our feet or our casters. I'm personally putting casters on this so I can move around the shop. Now, if you do get casters, make sure that they are level and casters, because most of the time you probably are gonna have the table stationary. So you wanna make sure that you can level it out, which will ensure that it is flat, which is the whole purpose of buying one of these tables. Now, this one's tab and slotted, like I said, so it just slides in and fits really nice in here. A little bit of play, but that's not gonna be an issue for what this is. Now, if you just have, you know, a plate that you drill and tapped, or if you drill the clearance hole and put a weld nut or a hex nut on there, that's fine too. Just face it up against. You can use a pipe clamp across and pin it down if you want to. I'm just gonna hold it here and use my thumb to keep it secure, but you can use a clamp if you're worried about burning your thumb. Now, if you do happen to put nuts on, make sure they sit inside a tube because you want this to be a flat, flush surface. So let's just get this thing tacked up. All right, so off camera, I got the legs down in the table face. Now go around and make sure that all of your legs are perfectly flush to the face of your table. You don't want to have to go back and try to cut in and just fix it. All right, so here we have our table flipped over. Now you can see we have really good coloration, so I know we got nice hot tacks. Now on these same tabs here, I am gonna add a little bit of weld on this side. It'll also help bring some of that distortion if there is any back and pull the table back this way. Personally for me, I prefer to just hit these with a TIG torch and just fusion weld them or just dab in a little bit of wire if I have to. All right, now the table's all together, the last thing that you're gonna have to do is level it off, whether you have the casters or you have just the leveling feet on, or you buy leveling feet yourself and have pads on them. This table just came with bolts. I would consider something with more of a foot onto it, but basically all you need to do then is just take a straight edge across, whether it be a level or a machine straight edge or something that you can trust is extra straight, and level it up so that way your X and Y axis are completely flush from end to end and corner to corner.
Whether you're a small-time fabricator or you're doing high-end professional work, or even if you're a woodworker, one of these tables is an absolute must for in your shop. So I want to thank you guys for watching the video and stopping by. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you on the next video.